you have a blog, you have a YouTube channel, you have Instagram, you have Facebook, and you have to create content for all these platforms, but you're not sure which content types that you can create. In today's video, I'm going to give you 10 content types that you can create for all of these platforms. Hey there, bosses, you're welcome to my channel once again. If this is your first time on this channel, I give you tips, resources, and strategies on how to make a living with your writing. If that sounds like your cup of tea, smash the subscribe button and the bell beside it to join our community and to get notified of all the videos that I post. All right, so the very first content type is list posts. Okay, this video is a list post because I'm giving you 10 whole content ideas that you can use on any of your blog, video, or social media platforms. And so create lists. And so a list could be 7 tools, 7 ways to do something, 7 methods, 10 ways to keep your skin clear. And so just come up with a list of tools, of ideas that you can share with your audience. And those always do really, really well because people are always looking for tools, ideas, how-tos, blah, blah, blah. So list posts. The second idea is to do tutorials and how-tos. And this is why YouTube is so successful, because a lot of people post how-to content. And so if you can create a how-to build a chair, how-to DIY this, how-to use this software, then people are gonna love that piece of content as well. And really, that is content that is really low-hanging fruit that you can create for any platform. Number 3 is telling stories. For instance, you can tell us why you made a particular decision for your brand. And so when I was changing the name of this channel from just my name, Gnontra, to Write and Prosper with Gnontra, I created a really short video explaining why I was changing the name to that. And that went over really well. And I find that because we're all people, we connect with stories. We love to hear other people's personal and human reasons for doing things. And so if you're able to tell a story about why you made a particular decision, about how you adopted a child, about how you did something, this piece of content does really, really well, especially on social media, but it can also do very, very well for your videos and for your blogs. 4, which is also along the storytelling line, is a day in the life. And I think a day in the life content, a lot of people attribute that to like lifestyle vloggers, but it really is something that anybody could do in any niche. For instance, a doctor's office, you could do a day in the life, and in the context of your practice, where you have your patients follow you on a video or blog of what goes on in a day in the office. And that's really interesting for them to see the behind the scenes of what you're doing when you're not seeing them, what you know, the phone calls, the fact that you also have a family life. And so it really is a powerful storytelling type of content that you can also share that always does well. 5, experiment results. Let's say that you tried going vegan for 30 days, or you tried drinking water for 30 days straight without doing anything, or something that I think the Wheezy Waiter here on YouTube does. One that I saw was like he quit sugar, him and his wife, I think, quit sugar for 30 days and what happened. That kind of content is really entertaining and really interesting as well. And it can be really used for any industry. And so you could, for instance, for me, I could tell you, okay, I wrote a book in 30 days. This is what happened. And so experiment results, something that you did that was out of the norm for you, that is really out of the norm for a lot of people, and the results that you got out of that. That's always a winner as well. If everything I'm sharing so far is making sense, I want you to leave me a thumbs up emoji in the comments below. Number 5 is a case study. And a case study is kind of sort of like a testimonial, but in a broader sense, in that you may interview a client, a customer that has used your product or service, and ask them what kind of results they got, what process they use, their whole story. And that's a really good case study. And so a case study is also another way, or it's kind of similar to the experiment results as well, where you share results from something that you did. The next idea is first impressions. You can always give your first impressions, and I see the makeup people do this quite a bit. Your first impressions of a new product that came out, your first impressions of a software that's out, give your first impressions. People always love that because it's a great way for them to know from somebody's eyes what that product is like before they make their decision to buy. Another piece of content that does quite well are the best of blog posts. And so if you're like me that has had a blog for the last 5 years, you have a lot of content, and sometimes you have the 10 best commented, the 10 most liked, the 10 most you know, the best of. Maybe you create a content on social media, for instance, and so you put up the 10 best resources on Instagram. And so look at your content. If especially if you've been creating content for a while, look at your content, look at the ones that have done really well, and you can create a compilation video, a compilation post, a compilation social media post, and post that, and people really enjoy that. The next content type are question and answer, Q&A type posts, and these are great because audiences always pose all types of questions. And so one of the tools that you can use that works really well actually is Instagram. And Instagram Stories has this question tool within Stories that you can use and get people to ask you questions. You could also post this question on Twitter, on Facebook, anywhere, and just read the answers out on a video or in a blog post or even on your social media. The next content type are books, and your impressions of the book, your thoughts, your takeaways from that particular book. It could be a video, it could be a podcast that you share your own takeaways. And those are always good because yes, it's content that somebody else created, you consumed it, and you're giving your own perspective of it. And that's also always great because people also want to see what your, you know, once again, first impressions. It's kind of like the first impressions post. And it gives them insights into that and helps them make better buying decisions. Next content idea is commenting on current events. And so every industry has a current event going on. They have some news, there's a breakthrough, there's something that comes up. You can comment on that on your blog, on in your videos, wherever. And that's also going to be fodder for conversation. Because when something first comes up, when right now as I'm shooting this video, Game of Thrones is on and people are making all kinds of comments. Yesterday I heard that two people died and people were flabbergasted, and so that's a conversation that's going on. And so this would be a great time for people to create that type of content around that particular event and have a lot of people flock to it, because during that time people's awareness of that particular current news event is heightened and they are looking for that content. And so this can really help you with search, with getting on that trending topic wave and get people to follow you, get people to become subscribers, and so on and so forth. If you enjoyed this video, then here is another video that I did on 5 tools and hacks that you can use to create even more content ideas.